My dear PPCRV volunteers, workers for the Lord, the gospel is very clear. Love one another. There are different kinds of love. The love of a mother for a child, the love of a husband for a wife, the love of a friend for a friend, the love also of a friend for an enemy. There is also love for the pet and the cat and the dog. There is also love of money. But there is also love of country. And you, my dear children, young people of PPCRV, you have chosen to express your love for God and love for country by joining the Parish Pastoral Council for Responsible Voting. So you were motivated, I know, I trust, by love. You love God deeply, you love the Catholic faith deeply, and you love the Philippines deeply. That is why you chose to be engaged in this undertaking. Not just for elections, but for responsible voting in between elections. But the question still needs to be asked. What do you do when it is very difficult to love? What do you do when people are hostile to you? How do you love when people are violent to you? Maybe violent with guns and knives and weapons, but also sometimes they can be violent with words. How do you love people who are hostile? People who are happy to see you get sick? How do you love people who want to see you dead? How do you love people who want to see you fail? And how do you love people who seem to be happy when things are not okay with you? I know you know the experience, because we are living in a world that is hostile, that is inimical, that is violent, that is dishonest, that wants us out of the way. You have many options, my dear young people. Pwede niyong gawin ay magpatakot tayo sa kanila. Magpasindak tayo sa kanila at huwag na tayong kumilos. No trouble. Tumahimik ka na lang, walang gulo. Magkulong ka na lang sa bahay, walang gulo. Huwag mo na lang pansinin, walang gulo, pero actually, pinansin mo na siya kasi ayaw mo nang kumilos. Kasi pagod na pagod ka na, ayaw mo nang masaktan. Or, you can choose the other way. When people are hostile, violent, when people want you defeated, when people want to kick you and crush you, you can also say, who you? Then you make them non-existent. Then you say, you do not exist in my life. I don't care about you. I don't know you. You are nothing. You can also do it that way. But you have to be very proud to be able to do that. So what do you do when people are hostile? When people are violent, when people are angry at you without any reason, pwede mong sabihin, inaano ba kita? Bakit galit na galit ka sa akin? Will you get paralyzed? Or will you just be proud? Lakasan na lang ng sikmura, hindi na lang kita papansinin. I can tell you, my dear young people of PPCRV, don't do that. Don't get paralyzed by people who treat you as enemies. But don't just ignore them and live as if they do not exist. Both are not good. Both are against the commandment. You know what you should do? Return to who you are. And who are you? Before PPCRV, you are a child of God. Bago ang lahat, tayong lahat ay kamukha ng Diyos. Bago ang lahat, tayong lahat ay anak ng Diyos. Yung nang-aaway sa iyo, kahit di mo siya inaaway, anak siya ng Diyos, magkapatid pa rin kayo. Yung gustong mamatay ka, yung gustong matalo ka, yung natutuwa kapag nalulungkot ka, kapatid mo siya kasi pareho kayo ng tatay. At ang pangalan ng tatay natin ay Diyos. So, when life becomes difficult and people make it difficult for us to love them, just return to who you are and always say to yourself, I am a child of God. And because I am a child of God, it is my nature to love. When we were in high school, I came across a parable of an old man who was sitting by the stream at nakakita siya ng isang dahon na lumulutang, at sa ibabaw ng isang dahon na yon ay mayroong scorpion. Sa hindi inaasahang palad, tumagilid yung dahon, nalaglag yung scorpion sa tubig, pero nagsisikap siyang makaahon. So, the old man, sitting by the stream, cupped the water with a scorpion. Kaya lang, pagkuha niya nun, kinagat siya ng scorpion, nabitawan niya dahil sa sakit. Nahulog ulit, pero nagsisikap na wag malunod yung scorpion, kinuha niya ulit, kinagat na naman siya ulit, at dahil sa sakit, nabitawan niya ulit. At inulit niya ng 3, 5, 10 beses, namamagana yung kamay niya, pinipilit pa rin niyang iligtas yung scorpion na wag malunod. At dumaan yung apo niya, at sabi ng apo, "Lo, bakit namamaga yung braso niyo? Parang nilalagnat kayo." Sabi ni Lolo, "Yung scorpion nalulunod, gusto ko siyang iligtas." Sabi ng apo, "Lo, kahit anong gawin niyo sa scorpion, kakagatin kayo niyan." "Tama na po." But Lolo said, "Just because it is the nature of the scorpion to bite, why should I change my nature to save? Kung likas sa alakdan na mangagat kahit kanino at manakit, bakit ko kakalimutan ang aking kalikasang gustong magligtas at gustong magmahal? The scorpion can bite you, can sting you. The scorpion can keep on stinging you. But my dear young people of PPCRV, no matter how hostile or violent or unkind the world may be, do not change your identity. Your identity is God called you to love, because your ID cannot be wrapped in plastic and hang on your chest. Your ID is love, and people will know who you are by your love. Thank you, PPCRV, for loving."